Here we're going to factor completely the polynomial 2x to the third plus 16x squared plus 30x. The first thing you want to do when you are factoring a polynomial is to look for the greatest common factor. I'm just going to write that down right now. The GCF. That's the first thing you want to do. You won't always find the greatest common factor that you can factor out, but always look for it. And to do that, first look at the coefficients, those numbers in front of the variables. And it looks like there's a 2 common to each of those. That is, you can divide out a 2, or we're going to say factor out a 2 out of every one of those terms. There's also an x common to every term. This won't always happen, but always look for this. Look to see if you can factor some stuff out. Now, what's left? Well, we have the x squared, because you think of factoring as the reverse of multiplication or the reverse of distribution. So you're thinking, if you were to distribute this 2x, 2x times x squared would give you 2x to the third. Now, what would you have to multiply by 2x to get 16x squared? Well, that would be 8x. 2x times 8x is 16x squared. And then what would you multiply by 2x to get 30x? That would be 15. Okay, so now we have 2x times the quantity x squared plus 8x plus 15. Now, with factoring, this is not the same as dividing out or like simplifying fractions where the 2x just is gone. This 2x sticks around. You've just factored it out. It's still part of this expression. So keep that tagging along. And now we're going to factor this trinomial that's left in the parentheses. Now, what would you multiply together in these first terms to get x squared? These are the first terms. Well, we're going to multiply an x times an x. So if you have an x squared out here in the front of a trinomial, and there's nothing else, there's just a 1 coefficient here, then you know it's just going to be x times x here. Now we're looking for 2 numbers that you would put in, so that such that when you multiply them, you would get 15. That's kind of the L, the last step in the FOIL, because remember, factoring is the reverse of multiplication. So if you multiplied them, you would get 15, and if you added them, you would get 8. So I make a little table here. I say, okay, we need 2 numbers whose product equals 15, and whose sum equals 8. Okay, I know you're thinking 3 and 5. Let's just check another one. Let's check 1 times 15. Yeah, that works out, because you know, sometimes you're going to have to try different ways of multiplying to get 15. But 1 times 15 is 15, but the sum is 16. So no, we're not going to use those 2 numbers. Okay, how about what you wanted to try, 3 times 5. That works. 3 times 5 is 15, and 3 plus 5 is 8. So that works. Okay, so our 2 numbers are positive 3 and positive 5. So let's write that in there. Plus 3 and plus 5. And just to make a clean final answer, I'm just going to write this one more time. 2x times the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x plus 5. And that is your factored version, or factored form, of the original polynomial.